You asked, we answer. Today's question is
marketing to motivated sellers in upscale neighborhoods.
Ooh, we love marketing to motivated sellers in all neighborhoods.
We do, and upscale neighborhoods are fun because they're not slums. Again,
yes.
It's nice to be in nice areas. People like nice areas, so it's
fun. One thing I like to mention to students oftentimes when they're trying to do bigger deals is find nicer, bigger, higher expensive, more expensive houses.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, squeezing in a 3 to 5, maybe even a 10% wholesale fee on a deal is very easy. But if the deal's worth like 15 grand, 10% of that's only 1,500 bucks, right? It's not a lot. So if you're trying to maybe make a 10% profit margin, go find a property that's worth 200 grand. And the 10% of that's 20,000. Now you have a huge fee.
No, that's a great point. So Dave, if a property is after repair value, if the ARV is only $50,000, you're never going to make a $100,000 wholesale fee on that $50,000
unless
property.
It's worth 400 grand ARV.
That's
right?
What I'm saying. Yeah, a 50,000 ARV ain't going to make you.
Ain't
going
to make it. Oh, the ARV, right?
Exactly.
Right.
Yep. So again, if you're, it's a great idea to market to higher end areas.
For that reason, in my opinion alone, higher, bigger deals or bigger spreads.
Yeah, bigger potential spreads, which is awesome.
Now, so the question was, though, go ahead.
Is how do you market to them?
Ooh, I love that.
So
it's the same way you market to anybody else. You hop on the phone. You pick it up. You guys got one of these? You pick it up. You dial. You find the person's number. You call them. You text them. You get an email. You shoot them an email. You drop a letter in the mail. Okay? These are the strategies that we use. How do you go about finding their information? Well, you can drive for dollars and use the tax records and skip trace, or you can go buy lists in these neighborhoods. What am I missing?
That's it, man.
That's
again,
it.
It's the same as you would market to other people. I mean, there's not much different.
And here's
guys.
The thing, guys. I own houses that are worth 6, 7, 8 grand. That unfortunately we buy some of these that we get stuck with and then we sell them. But I also own houses that are worth $600,000, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm the owner of both. It's no different if I own a big one or a little one. It's just people to people. So pick up the phone and reach out, call them, spend some money on marketing so they call you.
I love it. Yeah,
that's it.
It's really not that complicated.
You asked, we answered.